Good morning, sisters and brothers. How are you doing today? Good, good, good. Raise your hand if you ate too much for Thanksgiving. Amen. Amen. Raise your hand if you ate just enough. Amen. Amen. Raise your hand if you want more leftovers, if there's extras. All right, great. It's good to see everyone. We have so much to be thankful for. Let's keep the spirit of Thanksgiving going, just being thankful for what we have in this time. I want to welcome you to Crescentville United Methodist. I want to let you know that you are on holy ground. So like Moses, you can take your shoes off if you want, but recognize that you are on holy ground. You came here and you are meeting God here. Actually, God is always around you, but on Sunday mornings, we take a moment to stop and realize that God is right in front of us. So I pray that God speak to you today. I'm going to start off with some prayer and singing, and then we'll jump right into our special Christ the King service. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you, God, for this day. We thank you that we have breath in our bodies. We thank you that you have made us a family, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. So I like to start with a call and response. I often say the Spirit of the Lord is in this place because it just feels right to remember the Spirit of God is here. So I'll sing and you can repeat after me if you'd like. Or you can say that.
The Spirit of the Lord is in this place.
Jesus, for bringing healing and peace, comfort and joy to us. Thank you, Jesus. In your name we pray. Amen. 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 So I want to first draw your attention to the picture up there and in your bulletin. Jacob has drawn some incredible pictures for us each week. Jacob, if you could raise your hand. We'll recognize the artist in our midst. Thank you. Yes, yes, sure. I promise I won't make you stand every time. It's just, you know, we still get used to having an artist in the gathering. I'd like to just kind of announce Christ the King. So this is in your bulletin if you'd like to read along with me. Christ the King is the last Sunday of the season of Pentecost and of the church year. And this day completes the Christian journey through the life of Jesus Christ on earth and in heaven, which began with the preparation for the birth of Jesus in Advent. So it's going to be really cool. What we're going to do throughout the service is read a scripture in the Bible and then sing a song. And we're going to go through the whole life of Jesus in one service. So it's really fun to see all of Jesus' life laid out to you in just one service. See if you can follow along. See what pops out to you new and fresh. In John 18, when Pilate asked Jesus about his kingship, Jesus told him that his kingdom was not of this world. If it was, they would be figuring and fighting to keep him from being arrested. And we're reminded that Jesus went willingly to the cross. Violence is of this world, but our King Jesus, walked through a violent world as the Prince of Peace. Although his kingdom is not of this world, he tells us to pray, Father, your kingdom come here on earth as it is in heaven. And we ask today for Jesus to be the King of our lives, to be the Prince of Peace in our world, and that we help bring about his kingdom as we mean violence and hate with love and peace everywhere. So, on this King Sunday, Christians recognize and worship Christ as King of heaven and earth for all time without challenge, without end. It's not gonna be just a few years of kingship of Jesus, it's eternity. And in today's worship service, we're gonna celebrate Christ as the King with scripture and hymns that take us through the whole year. So, we have some announcements. First and foremost, I wanna announce December birthdays. So, the week before the month starts, we always do birthdays. For example, Rick Schneider is gonna be the third. Sometimes the first birthday falls before the Sunday, so we want to make sure everyone knows whose birthday it is. So as we celebrate you, if I read your name, if you could please stand up, we will then have a responsive reading together and sing happy birthday, of course. So Rick Schneider on the 3rd. All right. Mariah Jean on the 15th. Annette Dorba on the 16th. Zoramaya Dukes Van Gorder on the 23rd. She's like, what? Who said my name? The 29th is Edward Pei. Wonderful. Does anyone else have a birthday in December? All right, cool. Y'all are the lucky ones. So for our responsive readings, those standing, y'all will read with me the celebrants part in bold, and then everyone else in your bulletin, if you could read the people's part. Let's begin. We thank God for the gift of life.
Life is precious.
We are grateful for all of you. May God bless you in this time and throughout the ages.
We are glad that God has brought us together in this world.
We are enriched by those who come into our lives, our families, our church, and our community. May we always be open to seeing God in others. May we always follow God's leading into the future.
Thanks be to God for the gift of life.
Thanks be to God for the gift of life.
Amen.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you. And many more.
All right, we've got the gift of life. We are glad that you were born. Good work. Thank you for your mothers giving you birth. And it's wonderful to celebrate each other today. So also, we have some announcements. If you can turn right after service today, we will be staying to decorate the church to turn it into a Christmas wonderland, more or less. So please stay after service, grab your coffee and snacks, and then start decorating. We'll be decorating together. This Tuesday, so in 2 days, we're starting our Advent Bible study. So y'all are welcome to come at noon to 1:30 downstairs in the social hall. If you're not able to make it in person, we're going to be live streaming, Zooming it. So listen for us on email. You can get on in your work break for lunch. You can get on and participate with us. Or it'll also be posted afterwards. You can watch afterwards. But it'll be really beautiful. It'll be talking about what it really means that God is with us. God decided to walk around with us, to be here. So please join with us this Tuesday at 12 downstairs on Zoom. Also the 29th, we're gonna start Vesper services at the Philadelphia Protestant Home. So that's every Wednesday for the next 4 Wednesdays. At 7 p.m. there's gonna be some beautiful singing. It'll also be available live on the Facebook page. And then the video will be posted. And then at 7:30, the Bible story comes. But start at 7 for the singing. The 9th, The 9th, we're going to have a Caring for Friends cook party with the youth. So we're going to be trying to cook cookies and some snacks and some food, some dinner for people who are hungry. And then afterwards, everyone is invited to the Winter Wonderland at the farm. So that's this Saturday, so in 2 weeks, December 9th. That's going to be at 2:30 to 5 at the Carson Simpson Farm. Y'all can come. No matter what age, there's going to be lots of fun stuff for everyone. We're going to be as a church out on the farm, so bundle up. It'll be really a special Christmassy Wonderland time. On the 13th is Women's Fellowship at noon. Please bring a small dish to share. On the 17th, we're going to have the ABCs of Christmas and then a covered dish. So get ready for some good eats. Ed's here, so I'm just gonna throw you out there. That I was told that pepper soup is spicy, but Ed's pepper soup is on another level. So I don't know if he's gonna do it again because it was last covered dish. But I'm glad that you get your own level of pepper soup. That's good stuff. On the 24th, there is gonna be two services on Christmas Eve. So we're gonna have a 10:30 worship service, and then at 7 p.m. we're gonna have a candlelight Christmas Eve service. And then the 31st is going to be worship like normal at 10:30 with Christmas carol singing. So if you want to come out.
Oh, yes. But for the Bible study for Tuesday, since it starts at noon, just bring a sandwich, you know, your own sandwich, and we can take turns each week if somebody wants to bring a dessert to share. You know, we can, there's only four, so we can, you know, decide if we want to bring a dessert, we can share it the different weeks, and we'll have some drinks. So just bring your own sandwich to share.
And speaking of grabbing a cup of coffee after service prior to helping decorate, I made coffee this morning, and now we're out. Refresh everyone's memory. We work off donations for the coffee and the food after service. If anybody has favorite kinds of coffee, but I think we need to bring in some more coffee.
bring coffee. All right, so I would encourage you to just meet everyone. If someone wants to give you a handshake, it's good. A hug. Read the person in front of you, their body language. Singing it together.
Hi, Dad. thy new hand the faded and heaviness of crimson, and thy new gay household when thy dreams seem so high. Jesus, we ask thy new gay household in the meeting of our hearts. Thank you for reminding us of the lady for her. In faith, I believe in this church, in the faith of Christ, that I will be in this world forever. May we have the faith of our faith in us. May we bring about love and care for the Lord Jesus of you. And remember that the Lord will be in our faith and also in our faith. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
You may be seated. I'll ask the young people to come up in the first two rows, please. I want to ask you about kings and queens. Kings and queens. What do y'all know about kings and queens? All right, when I say, we'll wait for everyone. When I say king or queen, what comes to mind? If you want the microphone.
Rulers of a nation.
Rulers of a nation, yeah.
Mary and Joseph.
Mary and Joseph, yeah. Anybody else? You don't have to.
Like big houses?
Big houses.
Or castles?
Castles, yeah. Palaces, all that. Yeah. I'm gonna say leaders. Leaders. English, y'all have been Disney-fied. This is, yes, this is what kings and queens are in our imagination. And honestly, yeah, the King of England, the Queen of England, these people, you see them with lots of gold and like lots of crowns and palaces and stuff. That's true. That's what kings and queens are normally. Is Jesus that type of king? No. What does Jesus wear? Does he wear gold?
He wears regular clothes like
that. Yep.
What
else? A
robe. A strap.
A what?
A strap.
Strap, yeah. So I know Jacob made Jesus look real pretty, but in the scripture it says there's nothing that men should desire. Basically, Jesus looked real plain, maybe even ugly. We don't know exactly how Jesus looks. But in the scripture it says, you know, there was nothing about his appearance, his outer appearance, that men would desire him. So we imagine Jesus looking real plain, looking real regular. We imagine him in some regular people's clothes. Do you think that he had money, or was he like kind of in the middle, or was he kind of poor?
So at the time back then, his family didn't really have enough like money, like currency wasn't a lot.
Yeah.
Yep.
Dan probably didn't have money. Yes. In the middle. Okay. So Jesus was the son of a carpenter, which wasn't a great position. His mom was 13, 14 years old, which is normal back then, really young these days. But Jesus was poor. So when they went to Bethlehem, you know, if he was a real rich, important person, don't you think he would have been able to find a hotel? But what happened in the story? Yes? Say it again.
Home.
In a home, yep. And what happened when they were trying to, when Mary was pregnant? Yes. Jesus is the king of the universe, the king of the world, but he showed up, you know, to be born. His mom, you know, you think of a king's mother, you think of a royal queen. This was someone who everyone was like, oh my gosh, she had a baby, she's not even married yet. And then when they showed up to the little town of Bethlehem, They couldn't even find a hotel. They said there was no more room in the inn. Everyone's here for the census. And they weren't important. They were just regular people. And so they ended up having a baby in a manger with a bunch of stinking animals. So, all that to say, and then later when Jesus gets older, he says that, you know, foxes have dens to lay their, to sleep in, but the Son of Man has no place to lay his head. Basically saying, I'm homeless. Like, there's no place, I haven't made for myself a nice house. I don't have this nice job. Jesus just walked around and healed people and told people about the kingdom of God. So, it's funny, the last thing I'll say about Jesus being an interesting kind of different kind of king, when he came in like a big king procession, he was on, you know what he was riding? Was it like a giant elephant for a king or a giant horse?
He was riding a donkey.
Yep.
So, this is funny, because we say king, and we think of kings with like gold and power and giant elephants, and I think of elephants, maybe I don't think of elephants, you have to appreciate your head. But Jesus is really poor, might have been homeless, walked around plain looking, maybe even ugly. Maybe he wasn't taking showers every few times because he was walking on this dusty road. And then when he came in to claim his kingship in the capital city, he came in on a little donkey. This is a poor, kind of rejected person that now we see as a great, wonderful person, and he was always that great. But I think he came specifically to show us that even the people who we are just like, ooh, or they're like, they should be more, or maybe, you know, why don't they have a job or have a nice house like me? That was Jesus. Jesus was on the outside with the people at the bottom, and he was our king. So it's just something to think about. Like, God came as a king, but as a real humble king. Do y'all know what the word humble means? Yeah, I know we got a definition for me. Yeah, okay.
Peaceful and kind.
Peaceful and kind, yeah.
It's real gentle, not like lording it over you, being just with the people. All the people that no one else wanted to be with, that's who Jesus was with. He looked like them, dressed like them, walked with them, and that's the king that we celebrate today. A king that doesn't put on all the fancy airs, but a king that shows us that everyone is important. Even the people that we don't want to hang out with, everyone's important. Because Jesus was the most important, and he was like the lowest of the low. So that's my message to you about King Sunday today. I'm going to just transition into some prayers. Do any of y'all have any prayers that you want to pray about? Prayers that your trip to Florida with the cheering goes well. Praying for that. Good time. Yes. Your school's pastor has faithful cancer. So we're praying for your pastor of your school. Praying the healing for the cancer. Thank you, Laura. Praying for Jason for the results from the basketball tryouts. Alright, cool. Anyone else? I'll open it up to y'all. What do we want to pray about today? We can have a moment to really hear what's going on in each other's lives.
I have a concern that somebody got my Medicare. That's 1%.
So we're praying, Eva, that gets situated and you can get your Medicare. Thank you.
Good morning, George. I give glory to God Almighty for having this beautiful and my family this past week.
What happened here? What happened in heaven?
I have it. In granddaughter this past week.
Praise God, yes. What's her name? Is your name?
My name is Adele Rachel.
Adele.
Adele Rachel.
Praise God. Congratulations.
Job.
Joe. Is that your first grandchild?
No.
Seven. Cool.
Pray for Naomi, she's not going to work.
Naomi is not going to work? Okay, we're praying for Naomi. Thank you.
I'm praying for Sierra Leone. This morning they woke up with gunshots and shooting around the capital. Yeah, so prayer for Sierra. Thank you.
Thank you, Sierra. Thank you. Anybody else? Yeah. We'll go up here first.
A joy that today's my 18th birthday, and I also got acceptances from two colleges.
Oh, congrats.
Yeah. Wait, today is your 18th birthday? Yes. Oh, congratulations. Okay. Do you want us to say happy birthday? Yes, she said sure. Okay, stand up. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Naiva. Happy birthday to you. And many more. Yes, yes. 18. You are officially 18. Congratulations. And congrats on the two acceptances. Anybody else?
Hello, I just want to say hello. Thank you to everyone to be here with my family. And my mom was sick on Friday, so I'm afraid she gets better because she wasn't going to do
it. Thank you. So that's my mom, my mother-in-law, Sarita, and we're praying for Grandma Donna so she feels better. Amen. Anybody else? Alright, this is my favorite part of the service, to be to hear what's going on in each other's lives. Anyone else? Last call? Alright, let's pray. Jesus, we thank you for the chance to pray together, to hear each other's voice, to come before you together. Jesus, we pray for the Corral School pastor, Lord, for the cancer. Pray that you bring healing and peace. Lord, do something in the pastor's life, Lord. Do something in the school's life, God. Help them to all rally around and support this pastor. In Jesus' name. Lord, we pray for Eva, God. Help her to get her Medicare back, Lord. Help her to get that all just underneath, Lord, God. Help her to get the care she needs and just anything that's coming against her from just being, from getting what's hers. Help, Lord, fix that, Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for a new baby, Ellie. We thank you for a beautiful new granddaughter. And we pray a blessing on her. In Jesus' name, that she live a long, healthy, happy life. Jesus, we pray for Naomi, that she feel better, Lord, that she feel healing quickly in her body, Lord. Help her to get healthy again quickly, in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray for Sierra Leone. Jesus, as we hear about some unrest and shooting around the Capitol, Jesus, we pray for peace, Lord. We pray that you sent angels, Lord. We thank you that you already encamp around the people in Sierra Leone, and we just ask that, yeah, you just bring peace. Peace, Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for Naima, for her birthday today. We pray that, Lord, her 18th year is a blessing, Jesus, that you lead her into new opportunities, God, that you bless her life. And thank you for the college acceptances. Lord, we know that she'll end up going to the school that you have planned for her, God, so help her not to stress. Jesus, we thank you for Grandma Donna. We pray that she feels better, Lord. Help her to feel quickly better. In Jesus' name, bring your healing to her, Lord. For all these things and everything that we haven't mentioned or forgot to mention, Jesus, we thank you that you hear it all, Lord, that you pray on our behalf. So we lift it up. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. All right. I'll ask that you would stand for the Lord's Prayer.
As it is in heaven.
clothing was as white as snow, the hair of his head was white like wool. His throne was flaming with fire, its wheels were ablaze. You'll see where I'm reading, Daniel 7. A river of fire was flowing, coming out from before him. Thousands upon thousands attended him. 10,000 times 10,000 stood before him. The court was seated and books were opened. In my vision at night I looked, and there before me was like a son of man coming with the clouds of heaven. He approached the Ancient of Days and was led into his presence. He was given authority, glory, and sovereign power. All nations and peoples of every language worshiped him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that will not pass away, and his kingdom is one that will never be destroyed. So this is a vision that Daniel had of Jesus. So let's sing now, Majesty Worship His Majesty.
Thank you.
Jesus, we thank you that every good thing comes from you, God. Thank you that the next breath in our bodies comes from you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, for our health, our energy, for our families. Lord, we pray that our families receive healing and strength. Jesus, we pray that what we give to you, Lord, you use for the kingdom of God. Help us to give back in many ways, financially, help us to spread the kingdom of God. Lord, our very energy, help us to say a kind word, be loving, be a sense of peace and love in our families and in our communities this week. We give it back, Lord. Please use it for your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'll ask for the first, you can be seated. The little ones can be dismissed. The older ones, please thank the service. The little ones get lollipops if you all go back. I told Grandma that there will be lollipops. You have to read, yes. I'll invite Jason now to begin our reading through the Bible. Again, just you can read along. You can also close your eyes and imagine. We're going to go through the life of Jesus in a short amount of time. So hold on to your seats and just imagine this person growing up as a baby and then as a savior of the world. Try to imagine the whole Bible, the whole of Jesus' story in this next few minutes.
Mary said, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has been mindful of his humble seat of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the mighty one has been greatly for me. Holy in his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him from generation to generation. He has performed mighty deeds with his arm, he has scattered those who are proud and their inmost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their throne. Has lifted up humble. He has filled the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering us. Remember to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants forever, just as he promised their ancestors."
Jesus, born to set thy people free. From our fears and sins, release us, let us find our rest in thee. Israel, strength and consolation,
without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believe in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
There's a song in the air, there's a star in the sky, there's a mother's deep prayer, and a baby's low cry, and the star rains its fire while the beautiful sing, for the manger of Bethlehem cradles a king. We rejoice in the light, and we echo the song, that comes down through the night from the heavenly throng. Aye, we shout to the lovely evangel they bring, and we greet in his cradle our Savior and King.
And thus be killed after 3 days risen again. He spoke plainly about this, and Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But when Jesus turned and looked at his disciples, he rebuked Peter. Get behind me, Satan. He said, you do not have mind in the concerns of God, but merely human concerns.
he called a crowd to him along with his disciples and said, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take off their cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save their lives will lose it. For whoever loses their life for me and for the gospel will save it. What God is it for someone to gain the whole world, yet forfeit their soul? Or what can anyone give in exchange for their souls? If anyone is ashamed of me and my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, the Son of Man will be ashamed of them when he comes in his Father's glory with the holy angels.
Covenant I will make with them after that time, says the Lord. I will put my laws in their hearts, and I will write them on their minds. Then he adds, their sins and lawless acts I will remember no more. And where these have been forgiven, sacrifice for sin is no longer necessary. Therefore, brothers and sisters, since we have confidence to enter the most holy place by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way opened for us through the curtain, that is, his body. And since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us draw near to God with a sincere heart and with the full assurance that faith brings, having our hearts sprinkled to cleanse us from a guilty conscience and having our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold unswervingly to the hope we profess, for he who promised is faithful. And let us consider how we may spur one another on toward love and good deeds, not giving up meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching.
Is this, oh my soul, what wondrous love is this, oh my soul, what wondrous love is this that caused the Lord of bliss to bear the dreadful curse for my soul, to bear the dreadful curse for my soul. To God and to the Lamb I will sing, to God and to the Lamb I will sing, to God and to the Lamb who is the great I am, while millions join the theme I will sing, while millions join the theme, I will sing.
The next reading is taken from Acts 10, 34 to 43. Then Peter began to speak. I now realize how true it is that God does not show favoritism, but accepts from every nation the one who fears him and does what is right. You know the message God sent to the people of Israel, announcing the good news of peace through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. You know what has happened throughout the province of Judea, beginning in the Galilee after the baptism that John preached. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, and how he went around doing good and healing all who were under the power of the devil, because God was with him. We are witnesses of everything he did in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They killed him by hanging him on a cross, but God raised him from the dead on the third day and caused him to be seen. He was not seen by all the people, but by witnesses who God has already chosen, by us who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one whom God appointed as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. This is the word of God.
When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. Now they were staying in Jerusalem, God-fearing Jews from every nation under heaven. When they heard this sound, a crowd came together in bewilderment, because each one heard their own language being spoken. Utterly amazed, they asked, "Aren't all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that each of us hears them in our native language? Parthians, Medes, and Elamites, residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus, and Pilate, Phrygia, Pamphylia, Egypt, and the parts of Libya, and Cyrene, visitors from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs, we hear them declaring the wonders of God in our own tongues." Amazed and perplexed, they asked one another, "What does this mean?" Some, however, made fun of them and said, "They have had too much wine." Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and addressed the crowd, "Fellow Jews and all of you who live in Jerusalem, let me explain this to you. Listen carefully to what I say. These people aren't drunk, as you suppose. It's only 9 in the morning. No, this is what is spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy. I will show wonders in the heavens above and signs on the earth below. Blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the great and glorious day of the Lord. And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. The reading of the word. Thanks be to God.
There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place, and I know that it's the spirit of the Lord. There are sweet expressions on
God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come and judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated.
Brought him down when we, like sheep, had gone astray. Our shepherd came, and on his shoulders bore our shame.
God love.